Hello dear student, I welcome you all in Highway Engineering subject and the subject code is 1615504. Today we are going to see unit number 6, that is hill roads. In hill road, this is lecture number 6. Myself Daniel Swami, I am lecturer of Civil Department, GEMS Polytechnic College, Aurangabad, Bihar. Let us see the content of the lecture. In hilly road, today we will study about formation work for construction of hill road. Let us discuss about the formation work for the construction of hill road in detail. Formation work for construction of hill roads. First, it is necessary to construct the formation of or the finished profile of hill road. Before anything, we should it is necessary to construct a formation according to that we will construct the hilly road. So as to carry out the next stage of construction, such as protective work, drainage work and pavement, before that we should do the form work and it will provide a finished profile of the hilly road. Okay. However, a special problem are facing while constructing hilly road in steeps. If we are constructing a hilly roads, there will be a different problem, that is special problems will induce and we have to face in the time of construction of hill roads. Also, very steep terrain including hard rock and at high altitude. As we construct the steep terrain including there will be many hard rocks according to the increasing the altitude, and while constructing we should go according to that, and that will maintain and the form work for the construction of hill road at that time will be very important for construction of pavement and protective work and drainage work. Okay. Next is the construction of form work consists of the following steps. If we are constructing a form work, we should go through these following steps so that the construction of form work will be easy, as well as while construction of pavement, that time it will be very easy for construction. First is track cut, then is jungle clearance, then third one is earthwork excavation through soil and soft rock, then rock cutting, drilling, blasting and clearance. As we know that track cut, jungle clearance, that is site clearance, as I have written jungle clearance, that means many trees and plants or shrubs will be there, so we should clear that natural vegetations. And then the earthwork excavation should be done, though soil or soft rock will be there. Then we have to cut in the middle, we can get hard rocks, so we should cut rocks, or we should drill the rock, or we should blast the rock, and then we have to clear everything for the construction of pavement. Okay. First one is rock cutting. Let us see about rock cutting. If the rock strata slope downward into the hill side, the hard rock is permitted to overhang the road, forming a half tunnel, which means that जो भी मीन्स जो हार्ड रॉक अगर फॉर्म होता है बीच में, तो उसको हम लोग क्या करते हैं, अगर वो डाउनवर्ड फॉर्म में है तो हम लोग क्या करते हैं, उसको काट के आधा ओवर हैंगिंग कर देते हैं, आधा पे उसको रोक देते हैं. ब्लास्टिंग इज़ डन इधर फ्रॉम फेस और फ्रॉम वन और द बोथ साइड. If that rock is in the middle, mid of the road, so we can blast that road by both the side or by from the face of that rock. Okay, bore holes for the end attack and the face attack, and the, for the blast of hard rock. हम लोग क्या करना है कि उसमें बोर होल करना है. अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ओनली वी कैन फिक्स द एक्सप्लोसिव एंड वी कैन ब्लास्ट द रोड फ्रॉम द फेस एज वेल एज द एंड. इफ़ द स्ट्रेटा इज इंक्लाइन टूवर्ड्स द हिल स्लोप, अगर उसका जो स्ट्रेटा स्ट्रक्चर जो है वो इंक्लाइन रहता है टूवर्ड्स हिल स्लोप. ओके. द कटिंग इज कंटिन्यूअसली अंटिल द इनर स्लोप इज at a safe angle to prevent slipping, which means that if we are cutting continuously, the inner slope of that rock should be in an angle to prevent the slipping. It should not slip from the original position. In such case, the blasting and cutting is commencing from the top. अगर वो मतलब इनर फेस उसका फेस करता है और स्लोप साइड में, तो वो कटिंग और ब्लास्टिंग जो है कमर्शियल रहेगा अगर हम उसको टॉप से काटेंगे तो, ठीक है। इफ़ द रॉक इज़ ए सॉफ्ट और लूसिंग स्ट्रेटिफाइंग, अगर रॉक अगर सॉफ्ट है लूस है, द कटिंग इज़ कमेंस्ड एट ए पॉइंट ऑन ए हिल साइड फार अवे for above the formation level to obtain the significant batter for the inner slope, which means that when we are cutting the rock in the inner slope, so we should cut from the above so that the formation level will be sufficient and it will be in better form if we cut in inner type of slope. अगर अंदर की ओर काटते हैं तो वो overhanging रहेगा, वो अपना ओरिजिनल पोजिशन से मूव नहीं करेगा, ठीक है। एज यू कैन सी हियर, हियर इज़ द बोर होल फॉर एंड अटैक एंड द बोर होल फॉर द फेस अटैक। यू कैन सी हियर विल बी द एंड फॉर द, यू कैन सी हियर इज फायर्ड होल एंड द होल विच इज डिटरमाइन द क्लीव एंड द एंड टू फैसिलिटेट टू रैप्चर बट आर नॉट फायर्ड। These are the hole which is not fired, but you can see which is fully dotted, means fully, this is hollow one which is not filled with explosive, but which is the dark one that is filled with explosive, and this is the fired holes you can see here. According to this only, cleave hole will be, in cleave holes there will be explosive will be inserted and then we will blast that to cut the rock, okay. Blowing out the cliff face by firing large mine then dressing the slope is another alternative. After blasting the mine, there will be much more we should dress from the, we should do dressing to the slope so that it will give a proper form of slope. Otherwise there will be many undulation in the blast, and we should, after blasting a mine in that rock, we should clear that side for the movement of that. In actual construction, there is greater difficulty in removing the rock exactly to the required level and the grades. In actual construction, अगर जब हम blast करते हैं तो rock को clear करने के लिए, जब वो blast होकर टूट जाता है तो वो साइड से हमको clear करने में बहुत difficult होता है, इसलिए उसका cost of construction बहुत ज़्यादा होता है. Unless special care to be taken, blast may be slight shorter and required. जितना हमको रिक्वायरमेंट है उसी के अनुसार से अगर हम ब्लास्ट करते हैं तो हमारा साइट क्लियरेंस करने के लिए हमको आसान पड़ेगा, क्योंकि जो भी उसका डिब्रिस जो गिरता है ब्लास्ट होने के बाद, रॉक जो टूट के गिरता है, उसको हम लोग साफ़ करने में बहुत दिक्कत होता है, और बहुत अंडुलेशन होने के कारण उसमें हमको बहुत दिक्कत पड़ता है मतलब रॉक को हटाने के लिए. इट कैन बी ओवर ब्लास्ट द ड्रेन ऑन ए हिल साइड इज ऑल्सो फॉर्म. Blasting stone are usually for a retaining wall, backfilling and high retaining wall and appearance etc. जो ये ब्लास्ट होता है इसे मतलब हम क्या कर सकते हैं, वो यही चीज़ को लेके हम रिटेनिंग वॉल बना सकते हैं, चाहे उसका फिलिंग कर सकते हैं रिटेनिंग वॉल को, उसका बेसमेंट उसका मजबूत कर सकते हैं. अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ओनली वी आर ब्लास्टिंग दिस, ओके. नेक्स्ट इज prescribed work for the construction of hill road. Where the time available do not allow for blasting or blasting and tunneling work, cliff gallery or cradle are restored for a negotiation of cliff and precipice. That means that if time is available, we should not allow to cut a tunnel or blast a tunnel, okay. These are suitable only for a light vehicle or a foot traffic. As we know that if we are providing a cliff gallery, we should go through by foot traffic, or we can take light vehicles in a cliff gallery for the movement. It is considered only for a short term use and not for permanent roadways for a regular traffic. And this cliff gallery is used for a short term, not for a permanent thing. And this is for low or light vehicles. Okay, precipice work is more important in a strata. Should be deep inward for a face in order to ensure the safe attachment for a jumpers. Means when the work will start, it is important that the strata should be deep inward so that we should not face any problem, and we should provide safety for the jumpers. It holds fastening to the lesson and the risk of the rock falls, as well as when we are blasting that, we should see that the blast should not be maximum. According to the need, we should blast, and we should clear that so that there will be less risk of rock falls. Okay, if the top of the precipice is inaccessible, means अगर जो भी काम है टॉप में, अगर उसको हम कम से कम टाइम में अगर अच्छा से अच्छा काम कर सकें तो वो बढ़िया रहेगा. इट इज़ नेसेसरी एदर टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम बिलो और टू वर्क फॉरवर्ड फ्रॉम द फॉरेस्ट पॉइंट ऑफ द रोड. Means if we are constructing the road in hilly road, as well we can construct from below, or we can construct as far as from that cliff area. A log or a light gangway is projected forward below beyond the end to provide the platform for which holes is drilled. After that, logs and light gangways are provided is projected forward for the drilling holes, and that will provide the platform according to by the if we will provide the platform, then we can go from downward to upward. And the supports are fixed in advance, and the supports which we are provided which are fixed in advance so that light moving vehicles can go through that, as well as foot traffic can be done, can be used in that. Okay, as you can see here, here is the changes, and here is the jumper, and road barriers, here is the lasses or wired, here is the wedge, and this is fixed before. And if this is not fixed, this will not having support. Okay, and by fixing the wedge it will have support, and by this we can go up and up. Okay, cliff gallery. When board is not boring is not practicable, a light roadway must be carried out on timber girdle and suspended by the means of wire cable from a jumper driven at the top of the cliff. Cliff gallery अगर हम वो participate नहीं लेता, means वो cliff gallery अगर provide नहीं करते हैं, तो हम लोग को जो भी suspension मतलब क्रेडल लाना होगा टिम्बर का, तो उसके लिए हमको वायर केबल से मतलब उसको अटैच करके उसको प्रॉपर सपोर्ट देना है. द बियरिंग ऑफ द क्रेडल शुड बी टिल्टेड अपवर्ड, अदरवाइज व्हेन द क्रेडल इज ड्रॉन अवे फ्रॉम द फेस फ्रॉम द क्लिफ, द सरफेस विल स्लोप आउटवर्ड एंड बिकम डेंजरस. जो हम लोग क्रेडल डालते हैं तो उसको अपवर्ड के अनुसार होना चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर ऊपर से क्लिफ के ऊपर से खींचा जाए तो वो मतलब आराम से निकल जाए, लेकिन अगर वो थोड़ा सा अगर डाउनवर्ड पोजीशन पे रहेगा तो वो डेंजर हो सकता है, वो खुल नहीं पाएगा. ओके, एज यू कैन सी इन दिस इमेज, द जंपर्स आर प्रोवाइडेड, वायर्ड रोप आर प्रोवाइडेड, एंड चिजल इज प्रोवाइडेड, and you can see the road bearing. According to this only, if the cliff is in the top, and if we are providing the support, it is easily we can remove, and these are the larger stone to be prevented in the crater of living outward. Okay, these are the rocks you can see here. Next is retaining wall. Retaining wall are the most important structure in hilly road construction to provide adequate stability to the road and to the slopes. It constructing on a valley side of the roadway. It is also on the cutting hillside to prevent landslide towards the roadway. Dry stone masonry prefers to masonry in a mortar, as the form permits easy drain and steep waters. रिटेनिंग वॉल का काम क्या है कि वो मतलब इम्पॉर्टेंट स्ट्रक्चर है हिली रोड कंस्ट्रक्शन में, क्योंकि वो प्रोवाइड करता है एडिक्वेट स्टेबिलिटी ऑन द टू द रोडवेज एंड टू द स्लोप्स, एज वेल एज इट सपोर्ट्स द रोड टू रोड टू बी स्टेबल, एंड इट ऑल्सो हेल्प्स इन द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ वैली साइड्स ऑफ द रोड. इट इज़ ऑल्सो ऑन द कटिंग हिल साइड to prevent landslide towards roadway. If retaining wall is not provided, all the जो मलबा होता है retaining wall रहेगा तो मलबा जब आगे घसकेगा तो वो retaining wall के पीछे मतलब वो retain हो जाएगा, मतलब रुक जाएगा. लेकिन अगर retaining wall नहीं रहता है वो पूरा मलबा क्या होगा, मतलब road पे आ जाएगा. You can understand? As you can see in this image, this is the retaining wall and see, this is the cut, and this will be retaining wall that will be stopping that pebbles to come on the road. Okay. Summary of this lecture is all about hilly roads, and we have seen about the formation work of construction of hilly roads. I have referred from online source SK Kannan book and Ritu publication book. Thank you for listening this lecture. If you have any doubt, you can clear with me. Thank you for listening.